Welcome to this Good Friday service. As you are able, will you please stand for the call to worship? God is light, in whom there is no darkness at all.
Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world.
And we loved the darkness rather than light.
Seated.
Please join me in the congregational prayer, which is printed in your bulletins or on your screen. Today, the carpenter's hands are nailed to a cross. The King of Kings is crowned with thorns and wears the purple robe of mockery. Today he sets us free, himself imprisoned on a tree. Today is God's Friday. We come in worship. Amen.
I am the cross, fully dressed and ready to serve, holding tightly in anticipation. Standing seems such a simple task, considering past experience. Surely I can hold on for a while, but this time is different.
Thank you.
The moments spent holding up and carrying this one seem much longer. Hope that this would soon be over is giving way to hopelessness. My stamina drips down with every drop from his crown, down and through to the ground that temporarily roots me. I inherit this deep connection born in pain like I have never known before. I am beginning to question why I am strengthened for this purpose of holding up for display what was intended to shame, holding up the weight of this world. This is not what I signed up for.
I am the cross, fully dressed and ready to serve, holding lightly in anticipation. The moment has nearly come. I am thirsty. I am thirsty? No.
Thank you.
Haven't you been through enough? Why must I, no we, hold on for so long? Why extend your suffering for even a fraction of a moment longer? What are you trying to prove?
Oh, it is finished. Oh, I see. I feel it. What divine mystery this is to me, to in one moment feel the fullness of the burdens you carried, then to see that it was not your body that made holding you in place so difficult, but your spirit, that sustaining spirit, that loving and never failing part of you, that even to the last painful and unbearable breath would not give up on the world. The display, the words, all were on purpose. How selfish of me to want you back. Even I, who made so much suffering reality, who caused so much hurt, who put my purpose, my perspective, my job before your divine and unmatched purpose and light. Yes, I see. I feel it.
Oh,
I am the cross, fully dressed and ready to serve my purpose, holding on to the rags, the dressing that once was filled with the spirit of love we all need. I am the cross, sitting in confusion, wishing I had no part in this. Yet, I am thankful to have known this love. People see me, see what I held up, and are moved to tears. If only they could move beyond the flesh and recognize that the scriptures have been fulfilled.
Lord, let me never
I am the cross. Fully dressed and having served, regret my anticipation and wish another way, a less painful way, could have served God's purpose. Jesus, we wait here by your tomb carrying our grief. The grief of the betrayer, the grief of the denier, the grief of the crucifiers. We carry the grief of the lost, the heartbroken, the bereft. Upon you was laid the grief of us all. It is finished. God of endings, God of darkness, God of the tomb, God of dark days and great loss, be with us now as we wait with Jesus. Amen.